السلام عليكم. Dear students, welcome to our course Writing 1, Lecture 13, Process Paragraph. This is Chapter 14 in your book, The Write Start Book. We're going to talk about how to write a process paragraph. You know that sometimes you have to explain to your friend how to perform a specific task by telling the steps that you used. And that is what we mean by process. Process means explaining the steps necessary to complete a procedure, an operation, or an event. So again, what do we mean by process? Process explains the steps necessary to complete a procedure, an operation, or an event. A process is an important method when you are asked to develop ideas in areas such as science, technology, sports, medicine, and business. For example, you may be asked to write about the bus boycott during the civil rights movement, or you may have to give a report illustrating how to assemble a piece of machinery. Process has two types. There are two types of process. Either you use directional process or informational process. What is the difference between these two types? Directional process explains to the reader how to do something, how to bake a cake, for example, how to tune a car engine, or how to write a process essay. The goal or the aim of directional process is to enable the readers to do something or to duplicate some process after they have followed the directions. Here again, in directional process, after reading your paragraph, the reader will be able to duplicate. Duplicate means to apply the process that he has just read. But the informational process explains to the reader how something was made, or how an event occurred, or how something works, how a treaty, for example, between two countries was finalized, how the Panama Canal was built, or how a laser is used in medical procedures. Here, the readers only understand the information, but they are not expected to be able to actually repeat or duplicate the process explained. This is the difference between the two types. In directional process, readers will be able to duplicate and apply the process which he or she read by following the directions. In informational process, the reader is going only to understand the information but will not be able to apply or duplicate this process. Now, let's see if you understand the difference between directional and informational process. I want you now to read these topics and decide whether they are informational or directional process. You can write D for directional and I for information. Informational. Organizing the process paragraph. How can we organize the process paragraph? You have to follow the chronological sequence in order to avoid confusion. For example, if you are describing how to change a tire, the wheel of the car, the instructions would not occur as suggested here in this sequence. This is a poor sequence, but it should follow the chronological steps which are listed here on the right. This poor sequence begins with replace the hubcap. You cannot replace from the first step. This is the last step, replacing the hubcap. The first step is removing the hubcap, following these steps, ending with replacing the hubcap. Using chronological order, I want you now to number these steps to appear chronologically according to the steps that you are going to follow in these two topics. Here we have sending an email, and the second one is talking about stopping smoking. If one of the steps are not needed, you can write only X in the space provided. Transition expressions. In every paragraph, as we mentioned before in our previous lectures, we said that you have to use your transition expressions. Why? To connect the steps or the ideas and to add rhythm to your reading in order to be more interesting for your paragraphs, in order to be more interesting for your readers. So transition expressions are needed to connect the steps, are needed to add rhythm for your paragraphs, are needed to make your paragraphs more interesting for your readers. Here are the most commonly used transition expressions for process. Afterward, as soon as, at first, at last, at this point, before, begin by, during, finally, first, second, third, following, initially, later, meanwhile, next, now, then, to begin, until, upon, when, and while. The topic sentence. This is needed in every paragraph you write. Every paragraph, every type you use, you have to begin with your topic sentence, which contains two main parts, the topic and the controlling idea. And according to the type of your paragraph, you can add some other things in your topic sentence, as mentioned in previous lectures. Both directional and informational paragraphs begin with a topic sentence that clearly states what the reader should be able to do or understand after reading the steps of the process and why the process is important. Look at this example. Great dough, a delectable sauce, and a variety of delicious toppings are the three things you need to make a gourmet pizza. So here in this topic sentence, we have a topic. What is the topic? It is a gourmet pizza. This is the topic that you are going to write about. Okay. In controlling idea, you are adding the process, the steps that you are going to talk about in details. Here are the three steps. Great dough, delectable sauce, variety of delicious toppings. These are the three steps or ideas that will be explained later on after writing the topic sentence. The entire paragraph might read like this. Great dough, a delectable sauce, and a variety of delicious toppings are the three things you need to make a gourmet pizza. This is the topic sentence. Now you are going to talk about the steps, the process, by using first of all transition expressions and talking in details about these three steps. First, in a large bowl, pour half a cup of warm water, 1 package yeast, and 1 teaspoon of sugar. Mix well and wait about 5 to 7 minutes to allow the yeast and sugar to activate. Next, add 2 cups of flour, 1/2 teaspoon salt, 2 tablespoons olive oil, and another 1/2 cup of warm water to the yeast mixture. With a fork, stir the mixture until all the water is absorbed. Now, spread flour on a pastry board or table. Dust your hands with the flour and empty the dough onto the floured mixing surface. Knead the dough for about 10 minutes. Put the dough back into the bowl, drizzle some olive oil over the surface, cover with a towel, and place the bowl in a draft-free area. The dough will be ready in 45 minutes. That all was about the first step. Now, the second step. Second, prepare the sauce. Over medium heat in a saucepan, sauté a minced clove of garlic in 2 tablespoons olive oil. Then add 1 14-ounce can of crushed tomatoes, 1 3-ounce can of tomato paste, and basil, parsley, oregano, salt, and pepper to taste. After this, look at the transition and words used here. After this, reduce heat to low, cover, and simmer for 1 hour, stirring occasionally until sauce thickens. Third, and here is the third step. Assemble the pizza and toppings. Remove the dough from the bowl, punch it down, and spread it in a 12 to 14 inch diameter circle on a floured surface. With a spoon, spread the sauce liberally over the dough's surface. Then add some tasty toppings such as cooked bacon, Italian sausage, ground beef, pepperoni, shrimp, pineapple, peppers, onions, mushrooms, broccoli, cauliflower, and olives. Finally, top with shredded cheese such as mozzarella or provolone and bake at 475 degrees for 15 minutes until the cheese melts. Mangia. Mangia is an Italian word because this is an Italian dish, pizza. Now you are going to analyze the process paragraph. How? By answering these four questions. Question number one, what process does the paragraph explain? What the process? It means what's the topic that the paragraph explains. Number two, is the this process paragraph intended to be directional or informational? When you read the steps or the process, can you duplicate them? Can you apply them? So are they directional or informational? Number three, how many steps are there in the process? Name them, name the steps. We said that we have three steps. What are they? Number four, identify the transitional expressions in the paragraph. What transitional expressions are used in this paragraph? Now, as homework, you are going to use one topic and write a process paragraph about. You can choose one topic from these eight topics and write what a process paragraph, and don't forget to write your topic sentence clearly, then the support sentences, then the concluding sentence. These are the three main parts of any paragraph: a topic sentence, support sentences, concluding sentence. And in topic sentence, you can add any information related to the mood you are going to write. Here you are going to write about a process paragraph. So the process paragraph, the steps you are going to mention in the topic sentence. Self-assessment task or test, you are going to check yourself if you understand this lecture, this topic, by answering these statements. You can decide whether they are true or false, and please, if they are false, tell me why. Check your answers. Now we're going to talk about definition paragraph. Okay, the previous was process. Now we're going to talk about how to write definition paragraph. And this is chapter 16 in your book, the Write to Start book. Sometimes the writer uses words or terms or concepts that his or her audience may not fully understand. The readers may not understand these words. They are difficult for them. They hear them for the first time. So what to do? You can simply define these words. And this is our topic that we're going to talk about now. Simple definitions. We have simple definitions and we have extended sentence definition. Let's talk about the simple definitions first. Simple definitions are basic one or two sentence definitions. So in simple definitions, we use only one to two sentences, such as those you might find in a dictionary. There are three types of simple sentence definitions. What are they? Number one, synonym definition. Synonym definition supplies another simpler word that means the same thing. So you have a word that is difficult for the reader. You can add another word to define that difficult word. For example, we have this word that is ubiquitous. What's the meaning of the word? You may hear this word for the first time. It means everywhere. Cacophony means noise. Number two, class definition. Class definition places the word or the term in a broad group or a class that readers will readily understand. Then it provides a specific detail that differentiates the original word or term from other members of that class. What do you mean by that? For example, I have this word, a convertible. Okay, convertible, a difficult word for the reader to understand. You can add a class. It's a class, it's a broad group. This convertible is a member of what? It's a member of the class car. Okay, okay, but this car has many members. How to differentiate convertible from other members of the word class? By adding other definitions, by saying, for example, a car with a top that goes up and down. Adding this definition to the word car explains that this word convertible is different from other members of car. It differs, for example, from sedans. Sedans is a type of cars. Why it differs from it? Because it has a top that goes up and down. Number three, definition by negation. By negation, using negative only, you can add not. For example, here, a bagel isn't just a donut-shaped piece of bread. It's actually a unique type of bread that's boiled before it's baked. Definition is important because it clears the communication. Why it clears the communication? Because it depends on a clear understanding. Precise language is essential if you are to understand what someone else means. That the same word can have multiple meanings. You know that in English, one word has many, many meanings, multiple meanings. So the writer has to define these kinds of terms for the readers. Now let's have activities for these three types using synonym definitions. For example, here, for adding synonym definitions, if you have here, for example, chagrined, maybe you hear for the first time. What does it mean? So to be chagrined is to be embarrassed. It means embarrassed. You can do this activity at home. Use your dictionary. Some of these words are defined for you. The second activity is about the second type of simple definitions, that is using class definitions. In class definitions, for example, here, martini. Martini is a cocktail. So, martini is a member of cocktail. Cocktail is the class word. Made, in order to differentiate it from other types of cocktail, what we say? Made with gin and vermouth. To be distinguished from other types of cocktail. At home, please define the other words or terms, and some of them are defined for you. You can use your dictionary. The third type, which activity which is related to the third type of definition, is definition by negation. Example, we have hero. A hero is not, we place not here. A hero is not just someone performing an act of bravery, it is also someone taking care of his or her daily responsibilities. Again, define the words freedom, word job by adding negation. Now let's talk about extended definition. We said that simple definitions only have one to two sentences, but in extended definition, you are going to write one full paragraph. Sometimes terms such as self-esteem, love, and free speech can require much more developed definitions if they are to be fully understood. A simple one-sentence dictionary definition may not be sufficient, not enough to use only one-sentence dictionary definition. You may need to use an entire paragraph, one full paragraph, to define such terms adequately. This longer type of definition is called what? Extended definition. Extended means long. Extended definition can be accomplished by means of any of the modes of development. What's the meaning of modes of development? It means now you defined your term in the topic sentence. How can you develop it? Are you going to use more and more and more and more definitions? No, you are going to develop it using any type of the paragraphs that we discussed before. You can use, for example, description, some example, exemplification paragraph, comparison and contrast, as we will discuss this type in our next lecture, process, and so on. To help define your term, you might, for example, describe some of its parts or elements. This is description paragraph. Explain its process. This is process paragraph. Compare or contrast it to other like terms. Give some examples, exemplification paragraph. Explain what it is not. This is called the mode of development. It means the type of the paragraph that you are going to use after defining the term in your topic sentence. You may use one of these modes to develop your definition, or you may use as many modes. You can use two modes. You can use, for example, description and exemplification together in this mode, in this development of definition paragraph, or more than two, as you find necessary. For example, if you were writing an extended definition paragraph for the term soul music, you might choose one or several of the following strategies. Your topic is solo music. What mood are you going to use? For example, you can compare or contrast solo music, as will be discussed, compare and contrast in our next lecture. You can compare and contrast them to other kinds of music, such as blues, alternative rock, and jazz. You can set some examples of well-known soul hits. Examples, it means you are going to use exemplification paragraph. Describe its parts, lyrics, themes, musical motifs. So you are going to use description paragraph. A simple definition for soul music might be, this is a definition which is going to be stated in the topic sentence. Music relating to or characteristic of African-American culture. This definition is not enough. You cannot only define, use a simple definition like this. You have to use an extended definition. Okay, it does not give the reader the full flavor of just so how soul music represents a part of the American culture. Therefore, an extended definition might expand on this idea and be like this. Soul music is a combination and merging of gospel and blues to African American musical styles. This is a topic sentence. And it has the things that you are going to talk in details in the support sentences. You are going to talk about two things, gospel and the blues. Okay? For two African and American musical styles. You have two styles of music to talk about, American and African. Here you are going to talk in details. While blues praise the worldly desires of the flesh, gospel extolled the virtues of spiritualism. Okay? This opposition of themes was melded into wide-ranging and extremely diverse style, full of passion, pride, and optimism, mixed with the historical emotion of pain and discrimination. Whatever concept you are defining, use only those modes and strategies that are necessary to define the concept fully. Do not use techniques solely for the sake of variety. It means you can vary, you can use more than one mood in order to develop your paragraph, your definition paragraph. Definition is stated in the topic sentence, then it is developed in the support sentences. The topic sentence of an extended definition. Definition paragraph begins with a topic sentence that clearly states the terms. Even if you are writing an extended definition, you have to write your topic sentence. The mode of development that will be used to define the terms and why defining the term is important, because there are many different reasons for supplying a reader with a definition, and because there are many different types of terms you might want to need to define in your writing, your topic sentence must clarify why you are defining a given term. For example, are you defining a specialized term that is unfamiliar to most people? Okay, in your paragraph, you are going to define, for example, unfamiliar terms such as LASIK eye surgery or super string theory. An abstract term, for example, you have an abstract term that can have a variety of meanings such as freedom or indifference. It has a variety of meanings, so you are going to use the definition that you intend to use in your paragraph. A concept that is often misunderstood, such as liberalism, Generation X. Many readers do not differentiate or know the meaning of liberalism. So you have to use an extended definition, and you have to mention it in your topic sentence. A new slang or cultural term. Slang language is not clear for the readers, such as extreme support or anime. Here is an example of a topic sentence for a definition paragraph about being a high school freshman. This definition paragraph, read it carefully to understand how can we write a definition paragraph using a definition in the topic sentence, then developing this definition by using any mood we had before, any type of paragraphs. Entering new surroundings is a topic sentence. Entering new surroundings, being harassed by upperclassmen, and having 4 long years of school ahead of you make being a high school freshman a dreadful experience. Freshman means what? A student in his first year in university. The entire paragraph might look like this. Entering in new surroundings, being harassed by upperclassmen, and having 4 long years of school ahead of you make being a freshman a dreadful experience. This topic sentence, as you see, contains definition with what? With the ideas that will be explained in the support sentences. Here we have the first one is what? You have new surroundings. You have being harassed by upperclassmen. You have 4 long years of school ahead. So this makes what? A dreadful experience for a freshman. Freshmen become very confused when rushed to find classes in a labyrinth of unfamiliar hallways. They act like mice attempting to find their ways through a complicated maze. As you see here, we have description. Okay, so the development mood is related to description paragraph. Additionally, harassment by upperclassmen makes running the maze even more of a challenge. Veteran students play pranks on the unsuspecting newcomers, such as asking them for elevator and hall passes. Finally, being a freshman means having 4 more years of headaches. Just because you are new, teachers will have little leniency in regard to the quantity of homework given and the quality of the homework returned. All 3 factors contribute to the realization that being a high school freshman is a dreadful experience. This is a concluding sentence. So, all 3 factors, the 3 factors that are mentioned in the topic sentence. In this paragraph, the term being defined is high school freshman. This is the topic of the topic sentence. This is a topic that is defined, high school freshman. And the mood of development is by what? 2 moods. We have example and description. Using typical events that happen to freshmen. Okay, so as we said here in this paragraph, you use 2 types of paragraphs, simplification and description. Write a topic sentence for each of the definitions you wrote for practice 3. You wrote a topic sentence for freedom and job. You defined freedom and you defined job. Now you are going to write the topic sentence containing what? Containing the definition that you used. This is homework. You are going to write a definition paragraph about one of the following topics. We have 8 topics. You can choose one and write about it. Don't forget, in your definition paragraph, you are going to define the term in your topic sentence. This topic sentence contains what? 2 parts. It contains 2 main parts. It contains the topic and the controlling idea. The controlling idea contains the definition of the topic. And then you are going to choose a suitable mood to develop your definition paragraph. Either you use description, examples, process, narration or narrative paragraph, any suitable mood you can use. You can use more than one mood. And don't forget to add the concluding sentence, because as I mentioned before, when you are writing a single paragraph, it should include 3 parts. The topic sentence, the support sentences, and the concluding sentence. But if you are writing multi-paragraphs, no need to write concluding sentence in each paragraph. Here, chapter self-assessment, you are going to read these sentences and decide whether they are true or false. And if they are false, please correct them. Tell me why and write the correct sentences. And thank you for listening. Stay safe and healthy. Goodbye for now. best wishes. Thank you so much.